This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to convert decimal numbers into fractions. So here's the first example. I've got the number 0.19, and I want to convert this into a fraction. I'm going to show you two ways to do this. The first method goes like this. I'm going to take the number and rewrite it without the decimal point. So if I just leave off the decimal point, that would be 0.19. This leading zero doesn't do anything, so I can get rid of that. That's going to be the numerator for my fraction. For the denominator, I'm going to write a 1, and then I'm going to count the number of digits after the decimal point, the number of digits to the right of the decimal point. Well, there were two digits there. For each of those digits, I'm going to put a 0 after that 1 in the denominator. And now I've got 19 over 100. I can't reduce this fraction, so that's basically what I'm left with. So 19 over 100 is the fraction equivalent for the decimal 0.19. Now here's another way to think of this. I could take that decimal point again, that decimal number again, 0.19, and I could make it a fraction by using 1 as a denominator. But I wouldn't want to leave a decimal point in a fraction. I could get rid of the decimal point in the numerator by multiplying the numerator by 100. That would move the decimal place two places to the right. Would move the decimal point two places to the right, and I would just have 19. But if I multiply the numerator by 100, I've got to multiply the denominator by 100. Now that's fine, because 100 over 100 is just equal to 1. So if I do the multiplication, 0.19 times 100 is just 19, and 1 times 100 is 100. And I end up with the same answer, 19 over 100. So we can think of this two ways. In the first method, I just rewrite the decimal number, but without the decimal point. That becomes the numerator of the fraction. The denominator is going to be 1, followed by the number of zeros that I had digits to the right of the decimal point, the number of digits that came after the decimal point. The other method, I think of that 0.19 as a fraction with 1 as the denominator, and then I multiplied it by 100 over 100 to get rid of those two decimal places. And that gave me the same answer. Let's look at one more. So here I've got 2.105. Using the first method, I'm going to rewrite it without the decimal point, 2105. That will be the numerator. The denominator will begin with a 1, and I'll count the number of digits to the right of the decimal point. There are three digits there. So I'll put three zeros after that 1 in the denominator. Now I've got the fraction 2105 over 1000. I can reduce this. If a number ends in a 5 or a 0, I can divide it by 5, so I know I can reduce this fraction. Dividing the numerator by 5, 5 into 21 goes 4 times, there would be 1 remainder, and then I want 5 into 10, that's 2, there's no remainder for that, and then 5 into 5 is 1. So I've got 421, and 5 divided into 1,000 is going to be, let's see, 5 goes into the 10 part, 2, and then 2 more zeros. So I've got 421 over 200. If I want to use the other method, I'll take that 2.105, make that a fraction with 1 as the denominator, and then to get rid of those three decimal places, I'll multiply by 1,000 over 1,000. To get rid of three decimal places, I'm multiplying by 1 followed by three zeros. When I multiply that out, I get 2,105, that's my numerator. The denominator is going to be 1,000. And once again, I could reduce this number to 421 over 200. Okay? So repeating the steps one more time for you. One method would be to take the number, the original decimal number, rewrite it without the decimal point. Make that the numerator of your fraction. For the denominator, you're going to have a 1. You're going to count the number of digits after the decimal point and put that many zeros after the 1 in the denominator. And then reduce your fraction if you can. The other method would be to take your decimal number, make that the numerator of a fraction with the denominator as 1, and then multiply by a 1 followed by the number of decimal places you had, the number of digits you had after the decimal point. So like 1,000 over that number again, 1,000 over 1,000. That will get rid of your decimal point. And once again, you'll end up with the same answer. Okay, so you could do this either way. That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.